Welcome back, everyone. My name is Reed Havens, and I'm here today to show you a cool feature in both Power BI and Excel that addresses a common pain point that I like to try to avoid. So what I'm going to do is let me walk you through a little bit of the scenario that I'm referring to in terms of the issue that I have with how calculations and measures are organized in Power BI by default, and why it might be nice and actually really can be a huge benefit to create a separate folder or table that you can contain all of these in. So what we have here on the left is a standard fields list that we have in Power BI. We have our calendar table, customers, a bunch of information in our data model. And as you can see in our sales table, here's a lot of different columns and calculations and everything else. Now, personally for me, one thing that really bugs me in Power BI is that they are sorted alphabetically for both your columns and your measures. So we can see here, we have our all of our calculations with little calculator icons, all the DAX calculations. They're organized there alphabetically, and you can search for the name, and there are some ways to kind of find them, but there's no easy button to just filter to measures and change the sort order on that table itself. So what I'd like to do is walk you through a nice little feature in Power BI that lets you create a measures table that through a few tips and tricks will organize it at the top and give you something very similar to this over on the right. We have a measures table there under the fields list with everything organized all together. It even changes the little calculator icon from the table icon if you hide everything except for just the calculations in this table. So it's a really clean and efficient way to organize your calculations once it's in the model. As an added bonus in this video, we'll also talk about how to do this in Excel. But for now, let's just go ahead and start with Power BI and work our way from there. All right, let's get started. So what I have in front of us is a sales detail report, similar to what we saw in the slides just a minute ago. And what I want to do is alleviate that pain point that we see over on the right, which is a sales table that has a series of calculations and columns all sorted in kind of a random order. So to start with, to work towards that DAX measures table that I want to create, I'm going to go up to the top ribbon here, and I'm going to select Enter Data. And that's going to open up a manual table creator. Now there's a lot of other uses for this, things like disconnected slicers and a ton of cool functionalities you can use with this. But for our purpose, we don't need to do anything with the table creation. All I'm going to do is come down here to the name. I'm going to call this DAX measures. I'm going to hit Load. And I'm going to let that load into my data model. All right. And as we can see over on our right now, there's a new table under our fields list called DAX measures. Now there's not going to be much in it at the moment. Like if we open it up, we will see that there's the name and just a simple column in there. And what we're going to do is we're going to load a bunch of these DAX calculations and we're going to move them into this measures table. Now I would tell you that I wish that there was a nice and easy select all, or if I could drag and drop them into here. It's a question I commonly get during trainings. That's nothing something you can actually do, unfortunately. But once you've at least set this up and established it, any new calculations can be created in there. So let's go through the painful process just once of moving them, and we'll be good to go. So I'm going to select the calculation here. I'm going to go up to the modeling tab at the top, and there's an option here called Home Table. Now that lets you choose which table your DAX calculation goes in. So I'm going to change that from sales to DAX measures, and then I'm going to do the same rinse and repeat process for the rest of them in this list. All right, now with that being done, there's kind of a trick too to get it to show and change the table icon from a table to a DAX calculator icon. Now if we actually come up here to where our column one is and we right click on it, we have two options. We can either hide it or delete it. The goal being, on the report layer, the only things that can be visible in a table has to be just calculations. If anything else is showing, it won't do this trick. So as soon as we get either deleted or hide it, this will happen. So I'm going to delete. Confirm the deletion. Now I'm going to refresh the fields list by collapsing and then watch as I open it up again. There we are. You see that there's now the DAX measures is at the very top. So what it's doing is it's actually sorting alphabetically both fields separately. So the tables themselves are being sorted alphabetically below, and then that DAX measures table is being sorted alphabetically at the top. If I ended up with the multiple DAX measures tables, let's say I had one for DAX actuals, budget, and forecast, it would sort the A, B, and F in that order from top to bottom. And that's how it organizes it. And it's really as simple as that. So you enter your data, move your DAX calculations into the table, and then delete the column. And just to refresh, collapse and open the fields list. And now going forward, anytime you want to create a new calculation, all you have to do is right click the measures table, select new measure, and then it will add it directly to that table. All right, that covers it for the Power BI section. In the next portion, I'll show you how to do the same feature in Excel as well. All right, on to the last portion of our video. So what we have in front of us is an Excel report, very similar to the one that we just saw in Power BI, albeit a few differences that just Excel normally has from the Power BI desktop environment, but the same data model, and we're going to go through a very similar concept. Now, unlike Power BI, there's no just real quick and easy enter data button that is available for any of the queries or any data input that you have in the Excel environment, but there's still a fairly easy way to do it. It just requires maybe a couple of extra mouse clicks. So let me walk you through that. I'm going to come up here to the Data tab, where our query editor is. You know, like this is our version of Power Query in the Excel environment. And I'm going to go to Get Data. I'm going to go to From Other Sources. And down here at the bottom, there is something called Blank Query. And again, the goal is to create an empty table for me to put all of my calculations in. So in this blank query, the only thing that I'm going to type up here, let me full screen that, in this formula bar right here, is null, because I want one cell, one column, and one and just basically no data actually needs to be in here. The table needs to exist, but I don't need any physical data. Now, all we have to do after that is go to home, and we will close and apply it. But before we do that, let's just make sure we name it appropriately. So I'm going to go over here to Query Settings, call this DAX Tables here on the right, DAX Measures. Perfect. And like I said, I'm just going to hit Close and Load now. We're going to see that there's another query down here at the bottom. It's loaded that. It has put that into my data model that we can see over here under the Pivot Table Fields. And now what I need to do is to go ahead and move all of my measures, just like I did in Power BI, into this table. So I'm going to go to Power Pivot. I'm going to select Manage Measures down here at the bottom. And each one of these, similarly to Power BI, there's no quick move all function, but just go through them one at a time, and I will move them all to the to being stored in the new DAX Measures table. So in the edit settings, you have your table name up here at the top, change that from sales to DAX measures. And then after hitting OK, I'm going to rinse and repeat for the rest of them. All right, I've gone ahead and moved everything over into my DAX calculation table, as we can see right here. But there still is this little DAX measures column here at the top. Now, unlike Power BI, we can't just simply delete this. Excel does require a column to exist in the table itself. However, what we can do is hide it. So let's go ahead and navigate to our Power Pivot tab, go to Manage. If I navigate to my DAX Measures table, get the formula bar down a bit, there we are. I can right-click on the DAX Measures column, select Hide from Client Tools. Go ahead and close this data model. There we are. Now do you see that there's the little sigma symbol showed up next to it, and DAX measures is over here at the top with all of my calculations in here in my Power Pivot model. Same functionality as Power BI. Symbols are a little different and slightly different way process to set it up. But the end result is the same goal that we want, which is an organization between our calculations and our columns. All right, I hope you found this tutorial useful, and I will see you in our next video.